we are learning how to make this donut eating game, where whenever the panda sprite touches the donut sprite disappears. It's like the panda ate that donut. Let's improve this game by adding score and some special effects. So one thing I completely forgot was saving the game. It is very, very important that you save, and in fact I should have saved it much earlier, because if you know it crashes or something, then you will lose all the work that you have done. So I'm going to call it donut game and I'm going to save it. So now that we have saved the game, let's add scoring. As we learned in the balloon popping game, that scoring is very easy in mBlock, and what you need to do is you need to create a variable to track the score. So I'm going to go into variable programming blocks and click make a variable. You can name the variable whatever you want. I'm going to call it eaten, as in donuts eaten, and I'm going to say for all sprites. And now what we have, all these additional blocks here related with this new variable we have created called eaten. So what I'm going to do is drag out the change eaten block, and I am going to add it inside the if then loop. So what we are saying here is that when I start as a clone, forever, if the clone of the donut sprite is touching the panda sprite, first change this variable by one. That means it will be like, you know, one donut is eaten, and then when it touches again, the second donut, third donut, and so forth, and then delete this clone. The other thing that we learned in the balloon popping game was that when you create a variable to track score, whenever a new game is created, you should reset that variable. So I'm going to go here and I'm going to drag out set eaten to 0, and I'm going to put it here. So what we are saying is that when the green flag is clicked, that means whenever a new game is started, first you set the variable called eaten to 0, so that the previous score does not get carried forward. So let's test our code. So eaten is 0. Whenever the panda sprite touches the donut sprite, the score is increasing by 1. Now, if you don't like this variable name called eaten, then you can change that very easily. You go back and you go to variables, you hold the variable, and this a new menu will pop up and you will say rename the variable. I can call it donuts eaten. Now in the game, the variable or the score becomes more obvious as to what it refers to, that it's the number of donuts eaten. Now the second thing is that you know, the panda sprite is wherever it is in the previous game, and if I click the green flag, it still starts wherever it was. You know, better than that would be whenever a new game starts, the panda sprite should be bang in the middle. So we know the stage coordinates, that this axis is this point in the middle of the stage is x0, y0. So what we can do is we can go into the panda programming blocks. We can go to events, click out when green flag is clicked, and then go to motion, and from here pull out this block which says go to specific x and y coordinates, and here we can say whenever a new game starts, go to x0, y0. Let's test the code. So whenever I start a new game, right now it's the previous score and the panda is also in the same position as the previous game, but now when I start a new game, my panda comes in the middle of the stage and the score is reset to 0. Now let's do one more thing, that right now when the panda is going left and right, it's still looking in the same direction. So let's make it such that when the panda is going right, this is fine, but when the panda is going left, it should look to the left side. So to do that, in the panda code, in motion, we have this command which says point in which direction. So what we are saying is we are looking at this left and right command. So we are saying, so right now it's pointing in 90 degrees, which is this way, which is exactly what we want. So we are saying when it is tilted right, point in this direction. But when it is working to the left side, we are saying point in direction the other direction, which is minus 90. So we are going to put this, let's test the game. So now when we move like this, it's in this direction, it's in the other direction, but it is also getting inverted. So we don't want that. We want that it should face in the other direction when it's going left, but it should not get inverted. So to correct this, what we have to do is, in the motion blocks, if you scroll down, you have this programming block called set rotation style, and you have options here to say don't rotate, rotate all around, or rotate only left and right. And that is what we want. We want this sprite to only turn left and right. We don't want it to invert. So this, again, I'm going to just set it here under this, whenever the new game starts. So whenever a new game starts, we are setting some basic parameters. We are saying set the rotation style to left and right and go to x0, y0. Let's test our code. So I start a new game, and now when I go left, the panda looks to the left, and when I go right, the panda looks to the right. So this is much better. Now how about we also add a little bit of a walking animation? And we know that we can add a walking animation, because if you go into the sprite, you know that it has got two costumes. And if I quickly change the costume, you can see that the panda looks as if it's walking. So we learned this in another video. So let's do that, that whenever it's going tilting left or right, it should start walking. So from the looks, I'm going to bring out the next costume. I'm going to bring out the next costume block and add it here. Let's test our code now. So now we have got the panda walking. So when I start a new game, the problem with adding this animation is also that my phone does not have enough RAM. So, you know, the motion is not very smooth. So it's up to you. You know, if you have an old phone or a phone which does not have enough RAM, then don't add this next costume block. So I'm going to remove it because it's making my game too slow. But if you have a good phone with a lot of RAM, then you can add this motion block. But let's do some more things to make our game look more elegant. So what we can do is, in the donut where we are deleting this donut, we can maybe create some sort of an effect, like the donut is disappearing. So to create this effect in looks, if you go down where it says change color, and if you bring out the change color block, if you select the drop down, then within change color there are some very interesting effects, like, you know, fisheye, whirl, pixelate, mosaic, brightness, and ghost. You can try these effects, but I'm going to choose, you can try the other effects also, but I'm going to choose the ghost effect. So to create an effect that as if the donut sprite is, when it is eaten, it is gradually disappearing, we're going to use this ghost effect. We have to repeat this a few times so that it looks like, you know, the sprite is gradually disappearing. So I'm going to put this change ghost effect by 25 into a loop, and let's say the loop will repeat 5 times or maybe 4 times. That's like 100. 25 times 4 is 100. So I'm going to place this just before I'm saying delete the clone. So here what we are saying is, when the panda will touch the donut sprite will gradually disappear. So let's test the game. See, now when the panda touches the donut slowly disappears as if it was eaten by the panda. So these are just little effects that you can add to make the game look more engaging. Let's add one final thing, which is sound. So in sound, what we want is when the panda eats the donut, maybe we want some sound, like a pop sound or some other sound. So let's go into sounds. Let's drag out a start sound block. And right now it only has the pop sound, which is also okay. You can use the pop sound. So let me show you how the pop sound will sound. and I'm going to put it here. When touching panda, start the pop sound, and let's test our game. So my phone has become a bit too slow. I'll have to restart the game, but you understand that whenever the panda is now touching the donut, the donut disappears and it also makes a popping sound. You should save frequently. So keep saving as you write more and more code so that you don't lose your code. If you don't like the pop sound, you can always add a new sound. So you go into pop, you say add a new sound, and then you can look for all kinds of effects here. So you can try out. So I think I like this boing sound. I'm going to use this boing sound. So I'm just going to change the sound to boing. And now if I test. So now you have the boing sound and a disappearing effect. So let's add one final sound effect, which is like in the background, some sound should always play. So you can add a background sound anywhere in any sprite. I'm going to add it to the background. So I'm going to go to events, bring out a green flag clicked, go into sound and say play sound until done. So I'm going to go into add sound and I'm going to look for some sound. So maybe some, you know, dance kind of a sound. So I like this dance around sound, so I'm going to select this. So now what we are saying is when green flag is clicked, play this sound, but this sound is, you know, of a short duration. So what we want is that when the game is being played, this sound should always play in the background. So I'm going to go into control, bring out a forever loop, put this play sound in the forever loop. So what we are saying is when green flag is clicked, forever keep playing the sound called dance around. So let's test our code. So I hope you like this game and you will try making it on your own. You can always change the code. You can play with the code. So if you go into the donut sprite, you can play with the wait command here. And you know, that will determine how difficult the game is. If I reduce the wait, the game will become more difficult because the donut sprite will appear for lesser duration and you will have to take the panda sprite to that donut sprite much faster. Try out different things and I hope you will enjoy making this game.